Hello friends, welcome to our channel Learn and Have Fun. Many subscribers requested us to upload a video on total internal reflection. So here we are with this video. Today we will perform 6 activities and show you total internal reflection in different ways. If you haven't subscribed yet, then please subscribe our channel and press the bell icon to get the notifications. Please like and share this video with your friends and classmates. In activity 1, we will take a glass slab and place it on a tabletop. Here we are using 4 tablets to raise it slightly above the surface. Friends, these are simple vitamin tablets. This is just done to avoid unnecessary reflection of laser beam from the surface of the table. Pass the laser beam through the glass slab from one side as shown in this video. The light refracts on entering the glass slab. By refraction, we mean bending of light due to change in speed of light inside the glass medium. The light bends towards the normal inside the glass medium, and when it comes out in the air medium, it bends away from the normal. Basically, the refraction of light is taking place when we pass the laser beam in this way. Now, something different will happen if we pass the laser beam from the adjacent side. See what happened here. The laser reflects internally here. If you observe carefully, it is not the partial reflection or refraction, but here total reflection of light is taking place. This phenomenon is known as total internal reflection. In activity 2, we will show you total internal reflection in a prism. Pass the laser beam through the prism. We need to pass the laser beam at a particular angle to reflect it internally in the prism. We will talk about this angle at which total internal reflection takes place later in this video. Here, the prism reflects the beam internally at 90 degrees. We can place the second prism, and this prism also reflects the laser beam internally at 90 degrees. Here, we shift the laser beam laterally using 2 prisms. We have a high quality prism in which emergent beam is equally bright as incident beam. Laser beam can also be made to turn 180 degrees with the combination of 2 prisms. Watch this. Enjoy the fun with prisms, laser, and understand the concept of total internal reflection. The laser beam appears clear and bright in dark background. So, we have some shots for you in dark backgrounds. In activity 3, we will find the conditions under which total internal reflection of light takes place. We place a circular protractor on a black sheet on which angles are marked for easy reference. Place the semicircular glass slab on the protractor. Pass the laser beam from the curved surface of the glass slab. You will observe that the ray bends away from the normal. This means that the angle of refraction is greater than the angle of incidence. If we keep on increasing the angle of incidence, angle of refraction will also increase, and it will always be greater than the angle of incidence. When laser beam is somewhere near of 41 degrees, you will observe the angle of refraction is approximately 90 degrees. The refracted beam here in this experiment is extremely faint and it is not captured by the camera lens. This angle of incidence for which the angle of refraction in the rarer medium was 90 degrees is known as a critical angle. If angle of incidence is increased beyond the critical angle, then internal reflection will take place. That is, no refraction. The light is totally reflected internally in the denser medium. This phenomenon, as we discussed in activity 1, is known as total internal reflection, and the necessary conditions for total internal reflection to take place are: number 1, light must travel from a denser medium to a rarer medium. Number 2, light must be incident at an angle greater than the critical angle for that medium. Watch the video again and observe carefully what happened when angle of incidence was close to 40 to 42 degrees. There are some other media such as water, liquid soap, diamond, etc., where we can see total internal reflection. We have seen in the previous activities that the critical angle for glass was nearly 41 degrees. For different medium, the critical angle may be different. Here, we have taken liquid dishwasher in a clear glass bottle. On passing the laser beam through this, we can observe that the light is internally reflected 4 times before it comes out of the bottle. In activity 5, we are going to use a sheet of toughened glass. This sheet has many scratches, but still it shows internal reflection fairly well. Pass the laser beam through the sheet at an angle greater than the critical angle of the glass, that is 41 degrees. Observe that the light is internally reflected multiple times before it comes out of the glass sheet. Observe it one more time for better clarity. This is the last activity of the video and our favorite. Here we have a plastic bottle filled with water. There is a small hole near the base of the bottle. The hole is closed by a tape. Remove the tape. The water will not come out till the cap of bottle is closed. Pass the laser beam through the bottle in such a way that the laser beam travels through the water and comes out from the hole on the other side. After adjusting the laser, open the cap of the water bottle carefully. Watch and observe. The stream of water will come out from the hole and this is green in color. The laser beam appears to bend along with the water stream. This is one of the best way to show total internal reflection. The laser beam is reflected internally multiple times in water stream. Watch the laser spot on hand. This clearly shows that laser reflects internally and bends with the stream. optical fiber also works on the same principle. Even if the optical fibers are bent, rolled or twisted, the laser signal is able to travel through them. The internal reflections are not clearly visible in the water stream because the flow of water is turbulent. We will surely repeat the experiment with the laminar flow in future and share with our subscribers. Thank you for watching our video. If you really liked our video, please do share with your friends and hit the like button. This will motivate us to make more science videos for our subscribers.